everybody, Rich here. I apologize up front for the very crappy microphone audio quality, but that's okay because in this video I'm doing the screencast, so it's acceptable. I am showing how to do fast and easy audio mastering with Audacity version 2.1.0. You can get the software, it is free, for Windows, Mac OS X, or Linux. Just search for Audacity, A-U-D-A-C-I-T-Y. On Google, you'll find it. It's easy. Let's bring in an audio file. Now, this is what happens. Alright, make a copy. Yes. Okay, here we go. I use a Zoom R8 standalone recorder, as most of you who are subscribed to my channel are aware. The Zoom R8, very good unit, but a feature it lacks is the normalization of audio when going to master a file. For me, this is not a problem because I bring it into Windows afterward, and then I just master it here using free software. Now, the way that I get, and why do you do this? Well, first of all, is to get levels set correct, as in, you know, so it sounds good, so it's not too quiet, not too over distorted, and so on. And the second reason is so that none of the audio is chopped off when it goes to playback after uploading to specific services, which I'll explain in a moment. This only, okay, we'll do the audio modification first, and then how to compensate for when audio is chopped off on uploading to sites. So I have a master file in here. This is the master file for What Year Is This?, which is the video I posted right before this one. As you saw up here, you'll notice that the video, the audio does not go anywhere close to 0 dB. I got the best level I could out of the Zoom R8 so that I could have a good amount of level without distorting, and I'm okay with this because I'm going to bring it in here now and master it. Mastering requires just two steps: hard limiting and amplification. So first we do an edit, and where is it? There is select all. Now as you notice, when you do a select all, it darkens. If I did a piece of it, it would look like this, but we want the whole thing. So edit, select all, and then effect, and we're going to do hard limiting. Now this menu is really long. To get all the way through it, especially if you have a screen with a lower resolution, just use the down arrow on your keyboard like this. I'm pressing and holding down right now. It just keeps scrolling through all the menu choices. Well, anyway, the one we want, way down here, hard limiter. Now, ordinarily, it looks like this. The dB limit is 0, wet level 1, residue 0. The only one you need to be concerned with is the dB limit. The one that works for me in the way that I record is negative 6, as in minus 6. Now, if I go too much, which I'll show in a second, it distorts. Negative 6 works for me. If I do like a crazy level, like negative 15, and I preview that with start playback, you can hear the bass drums distorting too much. Negative 6, on the other hand, we're okay for the way I record. And I say for the way I record because when you do this, you might find a different level works for you best. Maybe negative 3 works best. Maybe you need something more like negative 8. You have to put on a set of headphones, listen for yourself. When you start to hear distortion, and not the good kind of distortion, I mean the bad kind, you just need to increase this number. So let's just say you do negative 6. Like, I could afford to go a little more, try negative 8. I don't know, I'm hearing distortion now, then try a negative 7. You have to experiment. For me, negative 6 works. I hit apply and close. This is what happens to the audio files. You'll see that because it's a hard limit, the peaks have been shrunk to -6 dB. Okay. Now what we need to do is bring this audio up. Now some of you may, especially if you're familiar with audio editing software, you may be thinking, well, this is compression, isn't it? No, there's a difference between compression and hard limiting. Compression will actually gain audio. It will gain levels when you squash it like this. Hard limiting does not squash. That's the difference between the two, the main difference. There are more differences, but that's the main difference. Anyway, so at this point, we're going to do effect, and then we're going to amplify to bring this stuff back up. Now, if you clicked accidentally, I didn't do it accidentally, but if you click, you deselect, make sure you go back to edit and select all, so this is still all dark, because we want the whole thing to be raised. So effect, I'll use my down arrow, oops, back to that menu, down arrow again, so I bring in amplify, which is the first or second one. Now, ordinarily, amplify will auto-calculate how many decibels you need to raise in order to get to zero. Well, when you do this for the internet, you can afford to overdrive slightly, and the audio will still sound okay. So what I do is it auto-calculated 6, because that is what is needed to go back to zero. Makes logical sense. But what I'm going to do is set a new peak amplitude of 1, which changes this to a 7. But you'll notice OK is grayed out. I want to allow clipping. And then I hit OK and watch what happens here. OK. Now, all the peaks have been raised. Now, why did I overdrive by 1 decibel? With music, at least with rock music, you can afford to go overdrive a little bit, because the highest level of audio is generated by the drums. The drums have a very short attack. Being they have a very short attack, even though it's slightly overdriven, you will not hear distortion. If I play back, it's a lot louder now. You can see, yeah, it's going over zero. But it is not distorting. And the reason it's not distorting is because these higher peaks are all short attack drum hits, and these lower peaks in the middle, that's where the guitar and bass is. That is why I can get away with doing it. Now the last part, this is pretty simple. In the way that they master audio professionally, like if you were going to press a CD or something like that, the thing to do in order to avoid having audio chopped off is to add 2 seconds of silence to the front of the file and the tail of the file. The original reason for doing this was actually for CD players way back in the 80s when they first developed this, console players. So what would happen is that in order to avoid audio starting too early or ending too early, they would add in 2 seconds of silence. Where the internet is concerned, sometimes when you upload audio files, even if it's within a video, the beginning of the file will be chopped off or the end will be chopped off. To avoid this, this is why we add 2 seconds of silence. In Audacity, it's very simple. You use these two buttons. This one goes to the beginning, skip to start. This one goes to the end of the file, skip to end. You click this one first, so it ends up here. Generate, silence, drop down this little menu, select seconds, and normally it's like, well, I did this before, but ordinarily it says 30 seconds. Just change this to 2 seconds by clicking and pressing the numbers on your keyboard and hit OK. So it added 2 seconds here. Click this button to skip to the end, generate, silence, seconds, and add another 2 seconds. So now we have 2 seconds of silence at the front, 2 seconds of silence at the tail. And if I hit play, you'll hear 2 seconds, well, here, there will be 2 seconds of silence and then the audio will start. Like that. What this does for you when you upload audio to the internet is that if any of the audio is chopped off at the beginning or the tail, it will only affect the silent parts. That is acceptable. That is okay, because you don't care if the silent parts are chopped off a little bit. That's fine. And then once you're finally finished with all this, just go to File and Export Audio, which will export a WAV file. Do you need to export MP3? No, you don't. SoundCloud allows for the upload of WAV. If you bring audio into a video editor, such as Windows Movie Maker, that allows, obviously, for the import of a WAV. You do not need the MP3. The WAV file sounds better anyway because it is not compressed. So to recap everything we did, first we did an edit and select all, then we went to effect, and we pressed it down a little bit here, and went to hard limiter. I changed this to -6 again. You will have to experiment with this to see which works best for you. You may even have to do it on a per song level, which is okay. Then I applied that, then I went to effect, and bring it into view. There we go. Amplify. It was at 6. It's already changed now, but it would have said 6. I changed that to 1 and allow clipping, and then I changed it into this. Then after that, I hit the skip to start, generated 2 seconds of silence from here. Skip to end, generate 2 seconds of silence there. And then finally, file, export audio, and save as WAV. Hey, that rhymes. That is it. That's all you need to do, and your audio should sound great for YouTube, for SoundCloud, for wherever you decide to post it to. Now, on a very final note here, will this fix audio problems if you have too much bass or too much treble or bad equalization in your audio? No, it will not. It will not fix that problem. This is just for final mastering. There are ways in Audacity to change the equalization levels, and you can mess around with compression if you want. But the point is this. If you're using a Zoom R8 or a Tascam DP008 or a standalone recorder and you bring a WAV file in here and you're otherwise happy with the sound, but you just want the levels to sound right, what I just showed you will work just fine. And that is all there is to it. So that's it, guys. See ya.